Most of us take motor car ignition systems for granted, until they go wrong, that is, and yet the vital sparking, which is after all what an ignition system is all about, has to take place at the right time and the right place, otherwise the car won't go. Sparking takes place in two main places, here in the distributor and again here, round at the spark plugs, one for each cylinder. And the distributor itself has two main functions, the first of which is a high tension function. It has to distribute. It distributes the charge of electricity coming up this high tension lead from the coil along these high tension leads down to the vital sparking plugs, and it does it in a predetermined order. And as distributors have a habit of being both gloomy and buried down the side of the engine, I took one out so we can see it a bit more clearly. So, having got the thing out, what do we find? We find, first of all, that there's a Baker-like cap at the top, like so, which is usually held on by spring clips like these. Sometimes they can be screwed on. When we remove that, we find the rotor arm sitting right on the top now, there. Now, the function of the rotor arm is very straightforward. What it does is to take the current that's coming through that central contact there from the coil and distribute it round the four other contacts so that the current can be taken down the high tension leads to the plugs. Rotates is driven by the engine just like that. Very straightforward piece of machinery indeed. Now, current thinking is suggesting that one ought to take a look at the distributor cap and the associated mechanicals roughly once every 6,000 miles. If you do, what are you looking for? Take a very, very close look indeed here at the distributor cap. You are looking for even the tiniest surface crack. If it's cracked in any way, throw it out and get yourself a new one. What about the rotor arm? What are we looking for there? Well, let's take a close look at it and take it out. We're looking at this brass contact on the end, which, as you can see on this one, is already getting a little bit grubby. If it's getting grubby, pitted or burnt, a quick go over with a piece of emery cloth will suffice. But if it gets too bad, again, you've got to replace it. The other function of the distributor is the low tension function. Low tension coming down this lead here, going to the make and break. The contact breaker points down there. What this does is to make and break the electrical circuit and generate action within the coil. Again, it's driven by the engine, like so. You can see the points opening and closing there. Now, this is the bit of the distributor that's going to require the maintenance, if any of it does. What we're looking for here is the correct gap between those two points. And we're looking for the correct gap when the points are fully opened, as there. How do we get them into that state? Well, it's simple. You put the car into, say, third gear, and without switching the engine on, you rock it forward, watching what happens until, just about there, the maximum gap is achieved. Now, I've set this up so there's an enormous gap there. The gap between these points should be about 25 thousandths of an inch. So, taking the feeler gauge, we stick it in and see what happens. And as you can see, it's waving around all over the place. What do we do about that? Screwdriver onto the retaining screw here, loosen it off, and then close the thing up like so. What we're trying to do is to get to a situation where that just slides in nicely, just like that, but doesn't rock around like that. So we'll make sure that's just right, and then tighten up again. And there we go, just like that. Other small maintenance tips. Well, when you're looking at the points, a spot of high melting point grease just in there between the activating heel of the points and the shaped lobes here on the shaft. A bit of lubrication there helps to prevent wear. And a couple of drops of light engine oil just in there where the rotor arm sits. But of course, like every mechanical device, your points will eventually wear out, and you will have to replace them. I can't tell you when it'll happen. It'll happen sometime between 6,000 and 12,000 miles, really, depending on how you drive. So you'll need a new set of points. When you go out to buy a new set of points, do make sure that you get the right set of points for your make and model of car, because they're all different, and that's very important. What else happens under the distributor cap? Well, that happens. And that little round box thing is the condenser. It's there for the best of all reasons. It's to stop the points from burning out prematurely. Condensers generally either work or they don't. How do you know if yours isn't working? Well, you know if there's a sudden dramatic fall off in performance, or if for some reason the car just won't go anymore and you've no real idea why. Well, then it could well be the condenser. And if that happens, change it. Now let's move to the other end of the ignition system, a point that's just as important as the bits we've already looked at, the sparking plug. You're looking for nice, tight, firm connections where the lead joins the top of the plug, and underneath there, you're looking for nice, clean, white porcelain insulating material and a nice, clean plug top. If you want to take the plug out, well, do it about every 6,000 miles or so for cleaning and for adjustment. By the way, you should reckon to replace a set of plugs about every 12,000 miles. Take it out, have a close look at it, clean it by all means. If you're going to use a wire brush, be very, very careful not to damage the porcelain insulation right in the middle there, and then have a look at the gap. Now, this plug should be set for 25 thousandths of an inch. In fact, it's considerably wider than that. So using a plug gauge, I'm going to close it up a bit, like so. Yes, there we are. Fine. 25 thousandths. You can also tap it down very, very gently using, say, the head of a screwdriver or something like that. And away you go. It may seem a little pernickety to worry so much about points and plugs, but frankly, if that whole ignition system is properly maintained and properly on tune, it will help you some way towards achieving those miraculous economy figures that you read about when you bought the car in the first place.